directly into the camera in 1, 2, 3. Thank you very much, Austin.
The ASEAN Australia Counter-Trafficking Initiative, which we're launching today, just days after the World Day Against Trafficking in Persons, demonstrates our shared commitment to stopping human trafficking.
Of the ASEAN Australia Counter-Trafficking Initiative, it is a great honour to have...
We welcome efforts to achieve a permanent peace on the Korean Peninsula, including steps towards complete, verifiable and irreversible denuclearisation of the DPRK. We remain concerned by developments in the South China Sea, including militarisation. The future of this international waterway is significant for Australia. The majority of our trade passes through it every day. We'll continue to take a close interest in ASEAN and China's negotiations on a code of conduct. We are also concerned about the situation in Rakhine State. We are committed to working with Myanmar, with Bangladesh, with ASEAN and other partners towards a long-term and durable solution. Development of a rolling pipeline of priority infrastructure projects for the region. And I congratulate... Last year, Australia spoke at this meeting about the kind of region that we want to live in. An open, inclusive and prosperous Indo-Pacific with a resilient ASEAN at its heart. And it's a great pleasure for me to congratulate you this year on the adoption of your own ASEAN outlook on the Indo-Pacific, which builds upon the ASEAN Charter and a Treaty of Amity and Cooperation. The outlook is a restatement of ASEAN centrality. It sends a powerful signal about ASEAN's commitment to the core principles of engagement in our region, including openness, transparency, inclusivity and respect for international law.
The political, security, the economic and the socio-cultural pillars.
Arrangements and the warm hospitality extended to me and my delegation will remain our preferred platform to further discussions. We want to see a strong, unified and prosperous ASEAN playing a central role in the emerging dynamic of the Indo-Pacific as it contributes to India's prosperity and security as well. In the Indian Ocean, like IORA, and with sub-regional mechanisms such
as... I don't need to request our media, but they are...